live from Miami Beach, Florida, extracting the signal from the noise. It's theCUBE, covering .next conference. Brought to you by Nutanix. Now your host, Stu Miniman.
Welcome back to SiliconANGLE TV's live coverage from the Nutanix inaugural .next conference here in steamy Miami. I'm Stu Miniman with Wikibon.com. It's been a lot of fun, day and a half here, going into Nutanix, the ecosystem, the customers, the partners, and there's no better way to really wrap up our segment. We have the first investor and the first board member of Nutanix, Bipul Sinha. Thank you so much for joining us on theCUBE.
Thanks for the opportunity. Pleasure to be here.
All right, so You've got a new gig. You're the co-founder and CEO of Rubrik, which we want to go in. But first of all, you know, you got to bask in the glow a little bit. You've got almost 1,000 customers here. There's a lot of excitement in the air. You know, financial analysts are keeping an eye. Everybody's watching for the IPO. Give us just, you know, an encapsulation of, you know, your journey with the Nutanix team.
I mean, this week has been a week of pride. And really, like, looking back when we started this journey on the three founders and I, We got together. I was the first board member. They started on this journey, and look at what company they have built. I mean, the technology, the product, the excitement in the ecosystem, and people are passionate about this product. I mean, one thing that I feel that Nutanix is not a company; it's a movement. It's a movement in changing the data infrastructure, changing the data center infrastructure, and really paving a new way of bringing new technology to the parts of the market that have not seen this kind of innovation before.
All right, so we heard in the opening keynote, you know, Ravi from Lightspeed and Vinod Khosla, you know, talk about it. But, you know, what really drew you to it? Is it people? Well, you know, was it the big idea? You know, was it the space was ripe for disruption? You know, some combination of all the above?
So really two things, the team and then idea. This idea of combining the compute and storage in a single tier and leveraging flash to really disrupt the data center architecture was a radical idea. It was a big idea. And as a venture capitalist, you want to go bet on an amazing team that can take on a big idea and make it real. And these guys did.
All right, well, congratulations on, you know, your involvement there, and, you know, kudos to the whole team. It's been fun to watch, you know, for all of us. So let's move to the next big idea.
Thank you. So give
us a little bit of the why of Rubrik.
So the inspiration of Rubrik came when we saw the big disruption in the primary environment where Nutanix combined the compute and storage in a single tier and created a fabric that is now the new compute fabric with all control plane and data plane and everything. And we looked at the backup and recovery space, and we are still living in the past. We have technologies from late 90s and early 2000s, and all this new stuff around virtualization and cloud and flash and large memory, this space is completely untouched by it. And we thought that why not create a single fabric, a scale out fabric, for backup and recovery. And when we thought about this idea of combining backup software functionality and globally deduplicated storage functionality into a single software that scales on commodity hardware, we found the new disruption angle for this new data center that is emerging.
All right, so yeah, take us a little bit into the architecture. If, you know, Dave Vellante's talked a lot about, you know, what we really need is kind of like time machine for the enterprise. I want push button simplicity, but, you know, it's not one size fits all. There's lots of environments to talk about. There's virtualization, there's cloud, there's lots of, you know, whole different apps out there. You know, how does Rubrik help solve that?
This is a good question. So the way we thought about the backup and recovery infrastructure, we said, if we have to invent the backup and recovery today, how would that look like? First thing is, no backup software. Because backup software was invented for tape. Tape is going to go away. We don't need backup software. We don't need to archive to tape. We need to archive to cloud, because cloud is the new infinite storage. So how do we combine the legacy infrastructure that people are running, take a modern backup, and then connect it back to the cloud? And that was the vision for Rubrik. So essentially, plug and play simplicity, and just like Apple iPhone, where you don't care about which service comes from cloud and which service comes locally, similarly the Rubrik device, you have a single panel that allows you to orchestrate your data on cloud as well as on-prem.
Yeah, so can you compare that with kind of some of the consumer solutions out there? So I've got a laptop-based cloud application, and when it first synced, boy, my machine had a couple of days that it was a dog. And if I go offline and do a bunch of stuff, boy, syncing again, it's painful. And if I need to retrieve something, I mean, I've got that long network between there. Data is tough to move. So, why is your solution, different? How does it solve that problem?
So we are not solving the end device backup. We are into the server backup. And so essentially application data backup and recovery. And we apply Flash technology to able to extract data from the primary environment really, really fast. And then we have the deduplication on a cluster in a very in a brand new file system that we have written from scratch that actually uses Flash and rotating disk to spray it on a cluster. So it's a modern technology. It's the first full snapshot and incremental forever, and then allow you to go, as you described, a time machine to any point in time in the past and instantaneously recover your applications.
Yeah, it reminds me the time machine. It's like CDP that we have. Is that still basically what we're talking about, that CDP technology?
So the technology is not CDP, but it is the functionality is CDP-like.
Okay.
It's an ability to go to any point in time in the past and be able to instantaneously recover your application, search for your data, and really get your users and application up and running in seconds.
Okay, so explain to us Rubrik, Nutanix, how do they fit together? What's the overlap? I understand, I can have a Nutanix instance that can go sit in Amazon for backup. So, shouldn't Nutanix just kind of pull this type of functionality into what they're doing? How do those two go together?
So Nutanix is a single fabric on the primary side. And think of us as the archival storage. So take data domain and build all the application intelligence into a single fabric that sits on the other side in the backup and recovery so that people can go back days, weeks, months, years, and they have compliance, governance requirement for doing that. Applications fail, they need a file data as of like a month ago. So we are in the archival space. Nutanix protection is more of a snapshot protection, DR protection, stuff like that.
Yeah, so I guess if you look, one of the other players in the market, Simplivity, would say, I can bake it into the stack, I've got multi-site, I can build a tier inside my device. Kind of give us the pluses and minuses of some of those decision points.
So this has been a discussion that has been going on in the industry for a long time. Long time ago, NetApp said, replicate and a snapshot, and that's the real backup. But Data Domain built a billions of dollars of business because people want physical isolation as well as code isolation to be able to protect their data and be able to recover from it when they most needed it. So our appliance, our solution is the storage system of last resort. When something fails, you come to us and we'll give you a solution, we'll give you your data back. And people want two different solutions. Simplivity may have a Swiss Army knife, but best of breed people prefer because have a deeper solution, we have more functional solution, and they need an assurance that if something goes wrong, they will be able to recover from it.
Okay, yeah, I mean, Simplivity's effort, they put a lot of engineering effort, they've got some good pieces. Oh, there's always, architectural decision points. We've been having lots of discussions, do you build in the stack or on top of the stack, and Nutanix even has made some changes as to how they think about that. Give us your thought, kind of the multi-hypervisor, multi-cloud world. Do you guys sit just at a kind of above that layer and you're agnostic to it, but support all the pieces as, things like Acropolis come out? How does that play into what you do at Rubrik?
So we are hypervisor agnostic. We are container agnostic. Our platform is a deep data management platform. And then we plug in like different hypervisor support. And we are super excited by Acropolis. And we are going to have a comprehensive support for it.
Yeah, you said containers too. I mean, most applications are pretty much stateless today in containers, but you've got some interactions or the capability to extend to that as more applications fit?
Absolutely, so as people move to container, and container is not a panacea for everything, but people who need container and they need data protection for the container, we want to be that solution. We have the right architecture and we are VMware, other hypervisor agnostic solution container agnostic solution.
All right. Can you give us the company snapshot, you know, where you are with funding, how many employees you have, how many customers? We actually had Bob Love from Bottomline came on, talked to you, said he's piloting your event, and today I even saw him walking around the show wearing the Rubrik shirt. So can you give us the company snapshot, please?
So we started about 16 months ago. We have 40-plus people in the company. We have 20-plus customers with us. We raised $51 million in capital from Greylock and Lightspeed, and we are going to build a very large company. There is a market opportunity in front of us, and we want to run for it.
All right, great. So give us you know, some of the milestones. What should we be looking for from Rubrik over kind of the next 6 to 12 months, product maturity-wise, so that we know what to look for?
So we just announced our GA, and now we are expanding, building national sales team and expanding our go-to-market strategy. We want to be the backup recovery solution provider wherever you are in the world.
All right, great. Bipul, I'm going to give you a last word. You know, to tell us, you know, give us a little, you know, your experience here at the show. You know, when's Rupert going to have, you know, their user event? No, I mean, I know it's too early, but just give us a little flavor, you know, what you've seen. Kind of help us close on the Nutanix show.
I'm, like, so inspired, so energized. The passion in our customer base, in the partner base, and what Nutanix has built is phenomenal. I mean, the energy in the ecosystem, and people are looking at Nutanix to really go define what it means to be a unified compute and storage platform for their applications, whether your application, running the application on-prem, on the cloud, everywhere, across different hypervisors, and going forward across different containers. Nutanix is the primary compute platform, and market is proving it.
Well, Bipul Sinha, you know, now with Rubrik, but also on the board, you know, for Nutanix, really appreciate you coming. Yeah, you know, definitely the vision is there to be the platform for the future. You know, time will tell as to how they can actually execute on it. So far, a lot of excitement here. It's been a pleasure to broadcast theCUBE here from the Nutanix show. See all the live videos from this show and future shows at siliconangle.tv. Research, as always, is on wikibon.com. Articles on siliconangle.com. One big shout out to the team, Dave Vellante. Had to go catch a flight, but really, really glad to, you know, be on the host here. Sam and Andy here locally in Miami. Brendan back watching it. Everybody, you know, watching, helping on the Twitter streams. The whole SiliconANGLE media team. It's been a real pleasure. Thanks so much. You know, check us out. Lots more shows coming up the way. Red Hat Summit's a big one. DockerCon, an exciting one. We're lots of planning for VMworld. If you want to be on the program, help sponsor the program, you know, please reach out to us, Twitter, email, or the like. All the websites have our contact info. Thanks so much. This is Stu Miniman, wikibon.com, signing off from the Nutanix.next conference here in Miami. Thanks so much for watching. Yeah.